Alright, now when you add the cream of the milk, first you want to bring your temperature down. So if you have a stove, you're going to turn the fire down to medium low. If you got a hot plate like we do here, just press the minus button. This is 180 degrees Fahrenheit, is what I turned it to. It's the random number, just turn it down. And now this is what our kamut looks like. We put it in a bullet and we crushed it up. Because remember, if you remember the video where we were at Big Lots and I said that the hole was hard, well, in order to solve that problem and make it more palatable, we crushed it up. And that's what's gonna help make our cream of kamut. And if I remember correctly, I believe this, I'm not too sure. Don't quote me on the gluten-free, and don't necessarily quote me on this. I perceive and I believe that this is good in terms of diabetics because it has a low glycemic index, I believe. So it's just a good, healthy alternative, and it tastes yummy. So now there's no, onto pouring the kamut, there's no specific measurement. What you want to do is it depends on your thickness. If you like things really thick, or if you like it soupy. So I kind of like it in the middle, and Mama likes it kind of soupy. So we're gonna do a, I don't even know what to call it, low, middle, slightly soupy version. But you'll see the end result in a moment. Yeah, I will it anyway. All right, let's pour in. And as you sprinkle it in, stir. Cause if you don't, it'll like to, kind of cluster on the surface there and want to stick together and be like, we're friends, we're all friends. And be like, no, we're not friends yet. You need to cook and get this stuff thick. So make sure you stir. All I have to say is make sure you stir. You don't want it all glumpy on the surface. Almost there. This is why I'm not necessarily cutting the stocking because it shouldn't take too long to get to your desired thickness. And because the kamut's all crushed up, y'all willing it doesn't take too long to cook either. And if you want to put butter in this, go ahead, feel free to put butter. What we do is, if it be y'all's will, you'll see how I add another oil into my little bowl of cream of kamut. In order to, mostly for health benefits, but it also makes it more rich. I also put some nut milk in it. Whether we got, I like almond milk, but I think we drink all of it. So put coconut milk in it, and that'll also keep it alkaline too. All right, so I know you can't see inside the pot really, but because the spoon has holes, hopefully it kind of gives you an idea of the thickness. But hold on, yeah, I'm willing to point the camera in the pot so you can get a better idea of what it looks like.